Hi everybody, I'm Amanda.
And I'm Brian.
And we're here at the St. Louis Zoo to talk to you about how we raise hellbenders. I'm gonna talk to you about how we raise the hellbenders from eggs to adults.
And I'm gonna talk to you about how we create the aquarium systems that we use to raise the hellbenders.
Now let's go get started. So here at the St. Louis Zoo, we're raising Ozark hellbenders because they're a federally listed endangered species. And we're raising them up from eggs all the way until we are able to release them back into the wild. Ozark hellbenders are found in southern Missouri and northern Arkansas. Hellbenders are a type of salamander, which is an amphibian, and that means that they live very close or in the water. Hellbenders can get up to about 2 feet long. They kind of have a flat body. Their head is very flat because it allows them to get underneath these rocks that they live in on the bottom of the stream. And they're really kind of unique too because they have a very long kind of rudder-like tail. It's kind of flat, which helps them swim through the water. We actually have captive bred eggs, and then we also have some that are collected from the wild, and we put them into our egg tray systems, and we take care of them in those egg trays until they hatch. And then once they hatch out, we put them into critter keepers inside of larger tanks. And it takes them another 6 to 8 weeks before they actually start eating. And once they start eating, it's a lot of work for the keepers because we go through with little pipettes, like little eyedroppers, and put the food in front of all the hellbenders so we make sure that they're all growing. As they get older, they get out of those critter keepers and go into the larger tanks. And we still continue to feed them. We feed them different food items as they get older. When the animals first start eating, they're eating little tiny foods because they're very tiny animals. So they get things like brine shrimp, and then as they get older, they start getting a lot more live food items. So we'll feed them ghost shrimp. Sometimes we get crayfish for them, and we feed them fish, and then also krill and a lot of other different frozen food items for them. So here at the St. Louis Zoo, we have over 4,000 hellbenders. And we go through and we weigh and measure all of them at least every 6 months. And the way that we can track the animals is that they actually have a chip, just like they put in cats and dogs. And we can scan that chip and we know which animal it is. So now that we've learned how we raise hellbenders, let's take it over to Brian and learn how we take care of over 4,000 of them here at the St. Louis Zoo.
Thanks, Amanda. We're down here at the Ron Gellner Center for Hellbender Conservation, where we have over 250 different individual hellbender aquariums. Just like your aquarium at home, we measure everything from water quality to temperature and oxygen in our exhibits here. For our hellbenders, we have several different types of systems for different sizes of hellbenders, from eggs to juveniles, all the way to adults. And you can see indoors, we actually have a man-made stream where hellbenders lay their eggs. So this is a really cool feature on our indoor stream system. It's called a biofilter, and it helps oxygenate the water as well as promote healthy bacteria in the system. It may look like a construction site in here, but hellbenders love to hide. So we give them PVC pipes and tiles to help mimic their natural behavior in the wild.
So I love my job and I love taking care of hellbenders because I know that if it weren't for us working with them, they'd probably be gone within the next 20 years or so. And knowing that I am helping to save them and to save this species makes my job completely worthwhile, and it makes me love it even more.